myself I was gonna be done playing around with the audio sliders, but it still looks exceptionally loud. So I guess I'm just gonna start with the combat tutorial. I assume that if there's a separate combat tutorial, that's not gonna really teach me that in games. Let's see how all this stuff works. Wow, this is a tutorial-ass tutorial. Over the course of your journeys across Ash, I assume that's the world, you will... Oh, I also need to... let's see... let's just try bottom left corner. See how that goes. And we'll see. I don't know where a good camera spot is, so I might end up having to, move this around a little bit. Over the course of your journey through Ash, you will encounter monsters and hostile denizens of the land. Combat is turn-based and requires the tactical use of your party's skill cards to defeat the enemy. Each hero brings a unique deck of cards to combat, representing their training, innate ability, and equipment. Okay. To win a battle, you have to defeat all the enemies on the map by reducing their health to zero. Here's your hunter and warrior heroes. Here your hunter and warrior heroes are facing off against a pair of injured charred warriors. Okay, so... Warrior, taunt. Once per turn, after you play a card and are adjacent to an enemy, defend 2 on all our heroes. I assume defend is some type of block. Oh, what just happened there? I mean, my bitrate looks like it's fine. Huh. To win a battle, you have to defeat all- oh wait, and then I was looking at this. Lethal. Okay, I guess that's describing what the lethal keyword is. Lethal, your first attack on a single target each turn deals +2 damage. Okay, straightforward. Then we got these guys. Oh, do they not have a hover over? Okay, so I assume the eyeball that's popping up on these is like a vision cone, so they're actually able to see that, whatever that is. And then, yeah, you can't interact with these in any way. To win a battle, you have to defeat all enemies on the map by reducing their health to 0. Here, oh right, I already read this, haha. Everything your hero can do in battle is driven by the skill cards you have in hand. Skill cards serve as your available actions and also the resource you will have to pay for those actions. Each member of your party has their own hand of cards highlighted on screen. Now, the color on the top of a hero's card matches the color of the hero's counter on the battle map. The color on the top of a hero's card matches the color of the hero's counter on the battle map. Okay, so these are green on the top and the little ring around the hunter is green and these are blue on top, which, okay. Figure it out. Sure. Okay, and so there is separate swipe cards that one is from like the warrior pile and one's from the hunter pile. Okay. Your skill cards are very versatile, as we will see. But we'll start by trying out some basic skill card actions. Okay. You now have 4 cards in hand. Each one of them has the following basic action: move, melee attack, range attack, defend. Did I just lose cards? Hover over each card in turn for a detail. Oh, why am I hovering over there that's causing that to pop up? Hover over each card in turn for a detailed description on the right. Oh. Why is hovering over the word right show this up? Maybe there's something behind this that I... of how each card works, and then click and drag from the cards to an appropriate target. The block card does not require a target, so simply drag it anywhere on the battlefield. Okay, makes sense. Okay, and then, so these must be mana cost, this must be mana, or resource cost, and whatever. And so, the movement here and the block here is costless? Seems odd. Okay. Melee attack. Oh, that's super loud. Hopefully that gets filtered out by the mic. Deals damage to an adjacent enemy. Melee attacks can provoke a combo strike from other adjacent friendly characters. Friendly characters cannot combo strike if they are adjacent to more than one enemy. Friendly characters cannot combo strike if they're adjacent to more than one enemy. Okay. Kind of like a area of control type mechanic. Makes sense. Trunks. I don't know where Trunks is right now. How do I call the Trunks? Wow, I did a giant sword swing. Why is my game being, or my stream being so droppy? Weird. Let's see if we can find Trunks real quick. There's been a request. Where is the cat?
Where is the cat dude?
He thought he could hide from the noise. He can never hide from the noise. Are you gonna be tall? Are you gonna be tall and chill? What do you think? What do you think of all the stuff that's happening on the desk right now? So what else do we got going on here? No extra stuff? Oh, block. Absorbs damage done to the character. All characters lose half of their remaining defense at the start of the turn. Makes sense. Let's look over here. What's happening over here? Wow. You're not interested by this screen, are you? If only you would notice the blue light at the camera, maybe you'd be distracted by that. Why is Trunks named Trunks? Is very much named after the Dragon Ball Z character. Or the Dragon Ball character. Is he in Dragon Ball as well? No. Dragon Ball Z character. All characters lose half their main defense at the start. Aren't you? Are you going to be a little Super Saiyan? Attack everyone. Okay, there you go. One second. We'll bring over his little cat bed here, and maybe he'll come back at some point, and I can just put the camera on the bed. Too old, don't know it? Isn't the Dragon Ball franchise ancient? I guess not. It can't be ancient, because, like, if the TV show was on when I was a kid, like, first episode 1989, like, I don't know, Dragon Ball Z is pretty old. I don't play Pokemon. Damn, got him. What else we got here? Range attack, deal damage to an enemy at any distance. Any distance is a big distance. May not be performed if you're adjacent to an enemy. Makes sense, blocked it by enemy characters, obstacles between the attacker and the target. Okay, so it's just why I probably can't do that attack. Hold right mouse button to preview line of sight to any space. Okay, makes sense. Okay. Sure. Pew pew! Move this character a number of spaces on the map. Move two and gain one willpower. Does it describe what a willpower is? Transors. No, I have no idea what a Transors is. That's one of the original Transformers, right? That's one of those Decepticons. What the fuck is a Transors? Or Transor Z? Wait, was I right? No, I wasn't right. I was pretty close with saying a Decepticon. If I'm not just right. What is this from? Mazinger Z. Yeah, this is some knockoff Transformers. Isn't commissioned by Toei Animation? I think they actually did do the animation for Dragon Ball Z as well. Yeah. Toei Animation? Wild. I guess they just really had a thing going with the Z names. It's not GoBots. I mean, it might as well be, right? Oh my god, I forgot what GoBots looked like. Man, yeah, that, never mind, that's some true knockoff Transformers shit right there. The more you know. There's probably a good reason why I would move to any of these spaces. Sure, move. I did a move. Excellent, don't worry if you didn't get everything straight. I mean, that's pretty straightforward. You can hover over cards to bring up at any time. Yep, descriptions. Descriptions are things. When you feel that you have done everything you can or want to do, click the end turn hourglass to finish your turn. Doing this will allow the enemies to take a turn and fight back against your heroes. Click on the hourglass below. Oh, that's where the hourglass is. I was like, I did not see an hourglass in this UI. After you click end turn, each of your heroes will draw 3 new cards from their personal deck so you have a fresh set of cards ready for their next turn. Now that you've picked up the basics of playing skill cards, let's learn about willpower. Okay, so willpower is like mana, energy, whatever. Most skill cards require willpower to play. The willpower cost is displayed at the top right of the card, the number in the center of the recycle shrine. That's a name, sure. At the top of the screen indicates the amount of willpower available to use. Why is that 0 then? You should be able to finish off one of the charred warriors with your power shot card. Yep. This card will cost 2 willpower, so first you'll need to generate 2 points of willpower. Oh, so that doesn't just refresh at the beginning of a turn. Oh, that's probably why I lost 2 cards before, was it just automatically traded them in for go points. That's basically what these are, right? Just go points. Oh, look at this. Drop a skill card here or right click on it to recycle. Recycled skill cards will be useful in a variety of ways. Generates 1 willpower to pay for other skill cards. Move the skill card. Move the skill card's hero 2 spaces. Okay. Unspent recycled cards provide 2 defense to their hero when you... Unspent recycled cards provide 2 defense to their hero when they end your turn. Huh, so it's a global pool up here, but it keeps track of what they have individually somehow? Huh. I assume that this is literally the same text that I just read up here. Any sealed card can be recycled to generate a single... So try recycling 1 card from your hunter's hand and 1 from your warrior's. Okay. So I need to get to 2. So let's recycle that, let's recycle that. Okay. It says the power shot, but isn't it smarter to swipe this here? Do what it says. Cool. Oh, hello. Hello, Mr. Teleporty Boy. In addition to generating willpower, any hero can recycle a card to move 2 spaces on the board. To assist your warrior, you can move your hunter up to engage the remaining charred warrior. Try this by recycling the remaining swipe card in your hunter's hand. Okay, right, and so this is to get, like, the combo attack off his swipe. You'll now notice that your hunter character is highlighted, indicating that he can be moved. Move your hunter to the space adjacent to the hostile charred by picking him up and dropping him with the mouse. You'll notice that areas adjacent to any enemy are highlighted with a crossed axe. Probably just show like zone of control, maybe? Now that your hunter is in place, you'll be able to assist your user. Yeah, use your swipe, do that, yeah. Oh, not enough willpower. So, even though this list 0 at the top, it's still gonna trade in for... Oh, that still gives you 1. Okay. Or maybe just each one of these is 1 and it doesn't matter what the cost is at the top. cool. Hopefully you notice that your hunter joined in with the combo strike for extra damage to finish off the charred. It didn't finish off nothing. Positioning your hero properly to take advantage of the terrain and combo strikes while limiting your opponent's opportunity to gang up on heroes is just as important. Okay, yep. Power, okay, yep. Big words. Trunks did not come back yet. Power cards are a different type of skill cards. Rather than having an immediate effect, power cards give your heroes ongoing bonuses. Sure, so just like powers in Slay the Spire. As before, hover over the adrenaline card and read its tooltip to the right of the card for an explanation on how to use powers and play it onto one of your heroes. Okay. Every time you play a card that deals melee damage, gain one willpower. That seems pretty strong. I wonder what the 8 means. Play on any hero to give an ongoing bonus. An active power is discarded after taking more damage than the hero's resilience value. An active power is discarded after taking more damage than the card's resist. So maybe that 8 is the resilience value? Each hero may only have up to 4 active powers. Okay. And so I assume it probably makes more sense. Oh, I assume I can't play this on the Hunter. Oh, I can play it on the Hunter. I assume because it's a blue card, it had to be played on the blue hero. Let's see. Well done. You can now view the powers active on your hero. Although powers provide ongoing benefit, each power has its own health or resilience. That is reduced whenever the hero takes damage from the cards. It must be that 8 though, right? Okay. Hover over the recycled shrine at the top of the reminder of each. You can always refer. Okay, so now it's gonna do some defending stuff. Try this now, but your hunter is still undefended, but you can use your remaining hero to. Any of your cycled cards that are unspent when you end your turn will be converted to 2 defense for the owning hero. I feel like there's a better way of explaining that, but okay, I get it. Okay, so the +2 says that if I end my turn now, it will get +2 defense. This is easy if you end your turn now. Okay, yeah. Defense before the enemy's turn as long as the recycled card is not spent. Okay. Is there a way for me to know how much damage that's gonna do? I guess not. Gain 1 willpower at the start of your turn. Okay. During the enemy's turn, hopefully you notice 2 things. Your defense prevented you from taking any health damage when attacked. Your enemy also played a power card. You can hover over the charred word and inspect the effects of any active powers. Don't forget you can force an enemy to discard an active power by damaging that hero. Okay, sure. Tutorial complete. Nifty. Oh, look, and I got another person. Well done, you've completed the combat tutorial and seen all the basic card effects in action. A few reminders. The reminders are missing. Oh, there we go. And then I assume this is just gonna... use what you learned to defeat the remaining charred warriors. Remember to refer to all the extra info that you can see. Cool. Oh, I didn't see. Okay, so we have 3 now. Okay. Well, every time you play a card that deals melee well, this was definitely not the right person to have that power on. That's fine. So, what makes sense here? So this is going to deal 3 damage. So if I swipe once, it's going to kill this, so I'm probably not going to need to use 2 swipes in this turn. So it feels like it's pretty safe to recycle one of those and then do this. Right, and they didn't have a melee attack here, so I wasn't going to get value off this adrenaline power anyways. So let's see, what does the elementalist have? The first card you play each turn costs -1 willpower. Cool. -1 willpower. Deals damage to so this is pretty similar to Power Shot. Magic attack 2 on a target within 3 spaces. and to one random enemy within two spaces of the target. So it will not chain there. Okay, and then that's just describing generally what a magic attack means. Okay. Deal 3 damage and inflict burning to all characters in a target area. So it has to be... So that means that it needs to be within... like that little... It's hard to tell exactly what that target indicator is trying to say. So I feel like I want to play this. Okay, so I can get within vision of at least that guy over there. Sure, that feels like it makes sense. Deal +1 attack damage. Okay. I feel like... I do want to move the warrior up. Let's get rid of this. Let's play this power. And then let's blow this guy up. Okay. Sure. I don't know how much these can move. That's just the vision cone, I think. It's probably pretty safe to assume... Oh, okay. So if you hover over their decks, you could potentially see what cards they're playing with if you had more details. Interesting. Does it suffer? But would that reach if I wanted it to? Deal 3 damage, inflict burn to all characters in the target area. It feels like this indicator is saying that, oh, well, now I don't get to play with it. Whoops. Let's see. Can I hit that guy? Out of range. Rip. Okay. Let's just do some movement stuff then, maybe. Let's move here and let's... I'm gonna assume they'll move up. Let's like move there. Let's see how this goes. Okay. So it moved to... It felt like it moved without having to, like, use cards. So maybe they just have 2 movement. That one moved a bunch, actually, didn't it? It moved, like, 4. In addition to their skill cards, each hero has a unique talent that you should be aware of. Yeah, I already read that. Talents are once per turn. Okay. Huh, why did she get 4 cards? Gain 1 willpower at the start of your turn. Sure, that seems like a good thing to just have. In most situations, you can undo your last action if you make a mistake or simply want to try something different. You can do this whenever you want by hitting the undo icon. Okay. Bonus willpower. Willpower plus. Okay. Sure. Oh, I think I do want that though. Deal 3. Okay, so like, I wish it kind of highlighted what was gonna happen here when I did this. Oh right, I have to recycle something, even though I have the... Or maybe the minus one is already being applied, and that's why it has the green one at the top. Okay, let's move up to here. Let's assume that they're both gonna die here, and then let's, maybe something like that. And then... Oh, he does not have any attacks this turn. Interesting. Probably don't need to advance twice. Oh, okay, so it does show up. Okay, so she would have to move to be able to use this effect. In 3 spaces in a random... Okay, so... Sure, let's skip that. Great. And then if I... trade one of these. I can move her here. Trade one of these. Do a blast. Okay. Nifty. Okay. Tutorial done. Wow. Let's see how this actually works in practice then. Choose the difficulty of your first adventure. Don't worry too much, you can change the difficulty whenever you start a new adventure. Easy, I don't have much experience with tactical combat or card games. Played tactical combat or card games before. I have loads of experience with tactical games. I live for synergy. That is how I describe myself, is that I live for synergy. My head is the best head I've ever had. This is the one head. Cataclysm 1. Does that imply that there's more than one cataclysm? Is there a cataclysm 2? The cataclysm was so good they needed to make a sequel? Oh, the first of a series of cataclysm levels. Okay, maybe if I was literate, I would know what's going on. If there's a harder level than the current hardest difficulty, I feel like I can probably just start out on hard. Let's just start here then. Hi Bodega, you finally getting pulled away from No Pixel? Did Kate manage to, or did Nancy manage to wrangle the herd of cats? Oh, Trunks, do you want to be photogenic? Here, let's see if we can have a cat cam. My face is boring anyways. Oh, we're going on a journey here today. How's this gonna work? Wow, this was artfully done. Oh, I should definitely just be looking at OBS, right? Isn't that more live than... Nope, not that way. There we go. Aren't you looking photogenic right now? I figured it out. Boom. I did it. He's like, why did you make all this noise? I know, how does he know? He knows that he's being seen right now and is shocked about it. Choose your quest. An infinitely replayable custom quest where the challenges are different every time. Play how you want to play your card. Instant boost in viewership. Oh, I need to... Oh, wait, no, I did switch back. It's so weird that OBS versus Stream Manager shows different... It changes the name colors for people. Bodega, what's your name color on your screen? What are these? Rescue your abandoned companions, hunt down a raffle deity. Oh, it has like the rough time limits. Yours is red? Man, this is all just made up in Twitch then. In my stream manager, your name is like a dark green, like a forest green. And then in OBS, it's like a burnt orange. So name colors apparently are just 100% made up. Maybe they never expected people to talk with each other and realize the difference. Probably don't need to do the daily challenge. Gather resources and power to defeat oncoming threats of neon. Well, it's not randomized. Like, you can go in and set it somewhere. I forgot where you can set it. Can't you set it somewhere? Eh, maybe it's all made up. Who knows? Okay, so party locked. Reach a total of soul level 9. Whatever soul level is. Defeat a total of 6 bosses. Complete a total of 5 side quests. Unlock 3 landmarks. Complete 3 different adventures. Spend a total of 70 crafting materials. This seems like a weird game to have crafting materials in. Okay, well, let's go for the short starter quest. That sounds like a good choice. Oh, I'm able to change names if I want to. Oh, I can change... Oh, change the gender as they're referred to in-game, but it doesn't change the portrait. Huh, okay. And then this is all just what I've read before. Okay. And then equipment gives action cards. Cool. And then the powers are coming from their armor, it looks like. For information on how to add your own custom hero portraits. Oh, that's cool. You can add... They have a fairly easy way of doing custom portraits if you want. Rivals. Oh, hello everyone. Interesting. Okay, well, let's just... Let's hit this begin. Let's see how this goes. Oh man, okay, we got some storybook-ass story stuff happening. Trunks, your head came off camera. Did I move that too far? No, it looks fine. Trunks is smart. Trunks knows that I don't know how to play this game. It's Hearthstone after everyone's died. That's my understanding. Oh lord, okay, I don't know if I'm reading all that. Not so long ago, Terralyn, I guess that's Terra. Terralyn was just a cobbled together refuge. I really don't feel like reading all of this. That's fine. You must travel into the Elven Palace to locate the legendary Waterstone and save your people from a drought. Okay, that at least is straightforward. Locate the rumored Elven Temple and retrieve the water gem for Terralyn. Most crops will not grow in this blasted land. Terralyn has relied on its hunters to bring meat from the beasts that roam the plains and to scavenge where they can. At first, the hunters were able to bring enough food to support the people by scavenging them from ruins of the living world. Finally, the solution is found in a living world tomb scavenged from the remains of a grand library, the location of a water gem, an elven artifact of great power. The text describes the stone being used to create a waterfall to decorate the palaces of an elven queen. Wow, talk about luxury. You ever felt like your home was just too peonish, and so you had someone create an artificial waterfall to liven it up? Well, if I'd have the product for you... No one needs to be reminded of the dangers of elven magic. Of course, we all know the dangers of elves. I mean, every rich person. That's true. Like, if I had FU money, I would definitely have a waterfall in my living room. The cause of the cataclysm that decimated the land. Those evil elves getting up to no good, decimating the land. What jerks. But after a month of watching the people of Terralyn succumb to hunger and disease, the settlement leaders decided that it's time to take action. Now, if only politicians in real life would realize that everyone's succumbing to hunger and disease and decide to take any action. Terralyn can only spare enough supplies for a small party of warriors and hunters to go forth and seek the gem. The scholars estimate the journey will take several weeks, so the party is given as much food and supplies as they can spare. The scholars can tell you little of the area beyond the immediate surroundings, but it's unlikely your supplies will last the entire journey. You'll need to scavenge what you can from the living world, etc., etc. Cool. The Waterstone is an elven artifact of unknown... Yep, so that's kind of generally what they just said. Elves, supposedly immortal creatures that can only be slain in battle or perish in natural disasters. Little is known about them other than the fact that they possess significant elemental magic ability. The elves are now thought to be all but extinct, their numbers ravaged by the fires of the cataclysm and the ensuing decades of persecution. That's fair. I feel like the people that destroyed the world probably deserve at least a decade of persecution. All the other races revile and fear the elves for bringing about the cataclysm. Have that shit on Wayfair, dude. How big of a fountain or how big of a waterfall are we talking about? Wayfair. Waterfall. Oh, okay. Yeah, they have a few options. Oh, some of these are pretty luxurious, actually. Okay. Like, a lot of them are kind of just the boring, like, have some water drip down some stones, but... Some of these is kind of a straight-up waterfall. You weren't wrong. Who would have guessed that a waterfall would be so reasonably priced? Okay, we've been staring at this screen for a while. Ooh, what do we got? Okay, continue. Let's continue. Oh, there's more tutorial words. Great. Welcome to Ash. To complete your quest to save Terralyn, you must undertake a perilous journey over the surface of a ravaged planet. Follow the golden objective marker to reach your next quest destination. Keep your supplies up and find weapons and equipment crucial to your quest. The party must visit points of interest highlighted on the map. During your journey, you'll need to keep track of your party's fatigue and morale levels. Are you just trying to gamify reading? Yeah, this is actually the entire game. It's just reading this book. This is actually a book about how to play another game that you purchase separately. Keep an eye on your party's fatigue level to keep them in top fighting form. To keep your party fresh, be sure to rest regularly. Huh, what an idea, Bodega. You should rest regularly to keep refreshed. You'll get the most benefit from resting in ruins and settlement where you can find shelter from the harsh conditions of Ash. Resting requires food supplies. I mean, does just everyone here like eat in their sleep? Does everyone sleepwalk and just eat food? That's a pretty odd trait for everyone to have. I guess they are in like a post-apocalyptic like wasteland, like who knows? Because of the urgency of your mission, you have a limited time to complete your objective before despair takes over your heroes. Yo, I feel that. Take some time to explore, but keep morale high by making steady progress towards your objective. Wild. So food supply, I guess we subsist on purely some scrawny carrots. Mystic herbs. Mystic herbs can be used to meditate while resting. Oh, so this is just weed. So they get high and meditate. If the hero has suffered an injury, two herbs can be used while resting to heal it. Okay, sure. Obsidian coins. Obsidian coins are most widely accepted currency on Ash following the events of the Cataclysm. Nifty. We're feeling determined. That seems like a good morale state there. And we're feeling fresh. Plus 35% stamina, plus 2 health. Okay. Still more reading. Great. You can view your party's inventory as well as the items currently equipped by clicking on the hero portraits on the left side. From here, you can manage and view your hero's combat deck by rearranging equipment. To return to the map, hit the map one. The game constantly saves your progress so you can leave and drop back at any time, but there's no going back on your choices. Be warned though, the land of Ash is brutal and unforgiving, and death's in trial of fire is permanent. If your whole party is defeated in battle, you'll need to start a new adventure, so be careful out there. Cool. Oh, thank God, I did want another tooltip screen. From your inventory screen, you can see the deck of skills. You had already told me this. You can customize this deck by leveling up. Try equipping or unequipping some items by dragging them from the anatomical slots. That's what I love to do, is drag and drop things from all of my anatomical slots on my character. To see the effects on your hero's deck, if you know what I mean. Click on the bookmark at the top right to return to your adventure. Okay. Okay, so my hunter with his big bow is using a crude spear as a weapon. That seems, yeah, sure. Oh god, okay, from the screen you can view your... Yeah, I think you had already kind of told me that. I know. How rare. I feel like he never cleans himself. Oh, you're so cute. God, why do I ever have a webcam pointed at me? That seems just like a terrible life choice when this is an option. Okay. Oh, right. I'm still not there. Oh, we have a thing. Okay. Where do I need to go? You would think after everything I just read, I would know where I need to go. So what is with this angle? This feels like a weird angle for this. Oh, are you bored? Are you bored of being famous? Oh, okay. Rip. I guess unfortunately, he is done with being a cooperative cat. Oh. How does this webcam thing work? Somewhere like that? Close enough. Man cat cam. I do not have the cat ears. Okay, I guess we just try clicking on a space and seeing what happens though, right? I'm getting a sense that based on that arrow pointing the other direction, I actually probably went the wrong way. The Sunken Causeway was a marvel of engineering in the living world. The road from the great Thyrin port of Freemark to the west and through the mountains was instrumental in establishing the Empire's dominance of the northern shore of Ash. So this place was called Ash before the Cataclysm? So before the world was destroyed, they still thought like, yo, we should name our continent after stuff that has been burnt. Feels like you're just setting yourself up for some problems there. The Thyrin Empire was known for its infrastructure and ingenuity, and having only recently settled on the continent of Ash, rumors say that the causeway was constructed in one night. Okay, they got some China-style infrastructure plans going on here. Stretches northwards through the mountains around you, much of the road is now consumed by the rising sulfurous waters. You find an abandoned Thyrin way station, half sunken but still containing a sealed storeroom. Okay, yeah, I'd say I should probably just take everything, right? Cool. Oh, yes, yeah, so if I had actually hovered over the arrow, maybe I'd understand what's happening here. So let's see. How do I judge whether something is better? Okay, so I can equip a second weapon if I just want to add a card to my deck. Melee attacks, 5. The target discards a random active power. I mean, that sounds like a good thing. Sure, let's just add that right on top. Spyglass. So what slot does the spyglass go into? Ah, it's an item type thing. Okay. Target a character to gain a copy of each of their active powers. Okay, so this is adding 2 cards is what it's saying? It is. Okay. Your next melee or range attack this turn deals double damage. Okay. And then this can be added to either. Why do I have the feeling that this card game is doing too much? What do you mean by doing too much? I don't know, like I've heard that it's not too bad with how it goes. With like the adding cards. I mean, you do only have 6 item slots, so it's not like it can get a ridiculous amount of stuff going on. There's probably a reason why I would use one, like put this on one character over another, but who can say? Is this just the same? Okay, so at the top left of the card, it has a symbol, and that specifies what type of slot it can go into. So it can only go into this left slot because that's the symbol it matches. And this is the same spell either way. So I assume there's no benefit. Oh, these are literally the same item. Okay. Sure. Wait, if I could add this to her as well. Oh no, it's saying I could add it to the warrior as well if I wanted to. Okay, let's just add it to this person. Okay. Let's keep on going. Maybe I overfilled that deck, but let's come back up here and figure our way over this way. Like, just give me cards with stats already on them. Why do they gotta equip your cards with item slots? It's a different way of doing it. It makes it a little bit more RPG game board, I guess. I don't know, it also makes it a little bit more conceptually easy to understand, like, why you're taking while you're removing one card and adding another card, it's not, you know, like right now you have a very fixed maximum amount of cards that you can add because you can only have like 5 or 6 item slots. And so you're going to be specifically trading out like a certain set of cards with a certain set of cards. It's not like, I know that you specifically, I don't think, know Slay the Spire, but it's not going to be that same type of system where you're just adding cards and removing cards separately. It adds like a give and take whenever you want to add a new card or remove a card. Judging by the broken slate headstone scattered around, it looks like you're in the remains of a human graveyard. Do I need an explanation of what a human is? The dominant race in the living world, humans suffered in a cataclysm. Wild humans are now scattered, subsisting in small groups, scavenging what they can. Robbers, bandits. Their susceptibility to the elements of the sun flares and the aurora storms has made them especially vulnerable in ash. There's a reason that the majority of the migrants traveling to Terralyn have comprised small groups of humans, and the skeletal remains of humans have been turned away from. Okay. Sucks to be a human. Got it. So let's see. We have a choice. Do we start digging up the graves, have a 50% of a reward or 50% of taking damage, or search among the things and just get coins? This is why I play soccer with cars and rockets. Some people just can't handle the big brain tactics of a card game, I guess. I don't know how good an epic or legendary reward is, so I'm just going to take money, I guess. You find the skeletal bodies of human woman under a pile of headstones. She has been caught up in the blast. You find a necklace of an emerald pendant around, which looks like it'll be worth a few obsidian at the market. Double my money. Cool. Okay. Oh, there's a nighttime effect. Interesting. Sure, let's see what this is. Wow, it got really dark. I didn't realize it'd be dark in the storybook as well still. You find someone that's recently been taken over by ratlings. Ratlings? Yes, ratlings. A primarily subterranean humanoid species that has proliferated through the cataclysm. Rats, they'll survive anything. Owning the fact that they were protected by their network of underground burrows. Ratlings are slightly shorter and leaner than humans, but they possess superior speed and agility and are able to move with great stealth. Males and females are difficult to distinguish in their... Okay, I know this word. Androgynously loose robes. Most clothing is an ill-fitting hodgepodge of styles and sizes, acquired through scavenging pieces of fabric. While their eyesight is reasonable during daylight hours, it affords them exceptional range and depth of perception at night. Since the cataclysm, ratlings have been the dominant species. Ratling society on the surface. Infighting, some ratlings have declared fiefdoms in former human. Okay, so we're getting kings and queens again. In the desperate battle for survival, since the cataclysm, the taking of the human slaves has become increasingly common. Dope. This game wants you to grind to earn a candle, which will unlock your night sight slot, which will allow you to read the 20%. Yep. No, I feel like you're probably right there. Which will ensure that you're equipping the right items onto the cards. Otherwise, there's a 15% RNG modifier. What's the number here? I'm buying things. Wish I had understood that before I just bought something at random. Was that something I wanted? Not really. Oh, well, sure. There you go. Now you have a throwing bone knives at people attack. There we go. Just what I wanted. I think I can change that a little bit. Let's just max brightness that. So if I hover over these so I get information. Okay, so there is a rough like judgment. Who need candle? God, it's so weird too with like the extra mini map up here. Can I cross this mountain? No, I can't. Okay. Let's rock out. Do I need more food at some point? Wasn't that a thing that was stated? Tired? I don't care about being tired. What's this? Settlement? Settlement sounds like a good place to go to. You enter a settlement and immediately hear a commotion ahead. You quicken your pace and spot several rattlings with weapons drawn, forcing a column of human people to turn over their possessions. Man, I feel like I don't want to be here right now. Intervene in the confrontation by confronting the rattlings. Ignore the humans, approach the rattlings' leader to barter. Bypass the town and say fuck it to everything else. It's Oregon Trail with different steps. See, it's completely different though, because we're going east, where everyone knows the Oregon Trail went west. Sure, we don't like... Well, I guess this doesn't say that they're slavers. I guess these are just robbers. I guess let's intervene. Let's intervene and let's fuck up some rats. Okay. Oh, look at the cute little rattling. I don't want to kill that guy. Okay, so they can't see shit right now because there's all these walls in the way. Cool. Probably, I assume that playing powers on your first turn is probably good. What else do we got? Okay, so these are all basic attacks. Probably using advance on her is also good. Okay, so she is not going to be able to reach anything. I'm probably going to use both of these as just mana. And get rain. Okay, so my hunter can just destroy someone if he can get in position. Except he can't this turn. Okay. Let's just do some stuff and see what happens. Fuck around and find out, right? Okay. And it would be so. I can spend one. I can only move two. So I don't think there's any way that I can actually shoot someone this turn. If I understand this correctly. Right? Yeah, because I would need to stand here to be able to get vision. I feel like I want to use two movement, though. Maybe I don't. I mean, these guys are definitely going to move up and be able to shoot back on their turn. Yeah, let's just take something kind of defensive. And then maybe throw this out to get a little bit more movement. Maybe hide behind this. There are rats. What do you mean? What did I say? Did I use a person pronoun, a human pronoun to describe them? I guess let's just do this. Let's just do this and end turn and see what happens. Oh no, yeah, these are armed rats that wanna fuck our day up. Oh, my hunter is going to get shot in the face again. Oh, nope, okay. Okay, that turn feels like it went well for me. So I have the one willpower from that. Melee attack or three... Okay, so let's see here. So I can probably kill this one. So I guess enemies block... Okay, so an enemy blocks line of sight. And so I would be able to hit those back two. I'd be able to hit these two if this one goes down. I wonder if my character also blocks his range. So like if I'm standing here, if I'll be able to shoot over my warrior. Deal 3-6 damage or deal 5 damage and block. Okay, so let's move up here. should probably think about... It's interesting that they all share the same resource pool, because it makes you kind of have to think about what all the characters are going to do before you necessarily do your action with one of your characters. Move 3, random ranged attack 2. That's kind of interesting. So how does... Oh, wow, okay. Random ranged attack 2. Well, like, running up and doing that doesn't seem to help much. May I just run to, like, here? Okay, so if I run up to here, this will deal 2 damage to this guy, and then I should be able to finish it off with, like, Wild Swing or something. And I can't... Oh, I could shoot just straight through here. Maybe that makes just as much sense. Okay, sure, let's try this. This seems really bad. It costs a lot. Did you say please? Maybe that will help. Should I have said please to the people attacking me? Or the people that are robbing the other people? Maybe that would have done it. Okay, I'm not gonna end up using this. So then let's go ahead and just schwang for 5. Okay, and so now am I able to... Okay, so I can shoot over my characters. Good to know. Okay, so let's do... I think I want to trade at least one of those in and do... Okay, so I can't hit behind. That's fine. And then if I was to running shot... okay, sure. Let's get that damage. Cool. Fatigue. On draw, discard this card. Okay, so it's kind of like a, whatever that card is in Slay of the Spire. The one that you just exhaust at the end of your turn. Oh no, I took damage. Okay, so maybe I should have spent some like energy defending that character since they're up front. Every time you play a card that deals melee damage, gain 1 willpower. Okay. Melee attack or ranged attack also hits anyone directly behind the target. If you hit 2 targets, gain 1 willpower. Interesting. Every time you play a card that deals magic damage, gain 1 willpower. Can you roleplay this, please? I don't know if I can roleplay this right now. Considering I don't know what half the things do. Every time you play a card that deals ranged damage, gain 1 willpower. Man, there's a lot of powers. I did not realize how many powers were in the decks. Right. I have 2 bonus willpower from the powers that these two have going. So this will kill this one with my improvised attack. So that seems good. And then what do I want to do otherwise? Probably just keep this guy right here. Probably play this power. And defend. Every time you play a card that deals ranged damage, gain 1 willpower. So probably go ahead and play that. Oh, it costs 2. I can do the reading. Let's try this. Let's not move, do this. Okay. And then... Force missiles. Probably the one. Why can I make it jump over here? Interesting. Sure. Is out of range. Right, that's how the reading do. Okay. And then I guess just get the one defense. Wait, why did he not, or she not get defense? I thought I kept an energy. Oh, I must have used it without thinking. I do not know what's being recorded tonight. What's being recorded tonight? On the 15th? Yeah, I have no idea. Dungeons and Daddies? Oh. They record this early. I guess that makes sense. It gives them the weekend plus Monday to do editing. Attacks. Okay, so this will chain if I use this. I wonder if I have the ability to end this combat here. So probably what I should have done was wait to discard this person's, my warrior's card so that they'd have the defense left over rather than being used up by everyone else. Man, these melee attacks by this hunter are kind of inconvenient. Just get rid of all of those. And then do this. Yeah, so I can't reach that. 1, 2. So I'd be able to go here and hit these four spaces. And I would be able to move it with that. Okay, so what do I have here? Melee attack 2, then melee attack 2. Okay. And this deals how much damage? Okay. I can't tell if this is a space, but I was thinking I could do like 1, 2. How does this target work? See, I'm thinking that like, if I move this person up, and then I can move her here. Oh wait, I could just move up one, and do the 3 damage here. And then I can move them up to here, and kill with double strike. I think I have lethal this turn, right? Oh, except this has area control. Okay, that's... Oh, I'm a little boned here now. Whoops. Right, because I can't, like... I assume that this is going to use the 2 energy I want to use for defense here. I assume I can't... Oh, I can rewind that far. Okay. Okay, so I want to... Oh wait, defend 2 after performing a melee attack. Okay, so what if I do like this, move up, burn that, do this. Okay. And then I guess I'll just like move here and then end my turn. Okay. I don't know what happens when I get to the bottom of my deck. Oh, click to redraw hand. Oh! Right, I forgot that I can redraw if I want to. Oh, cards I don't use, I keep in my hand. I probably shouldn't just be burning them like I was. Okay. More knowledge. Wow. Knowledge is all the battle, or whatever. Okay, I assume this is just gonna fall apart pretty quickly from here. Okay, a little rough. Warrior took more damage than she really needed to. And then what's this? some quick stamp. What does this click a hero to level them up. Okay, well, if I level up the warrior, does she heal? Oh, lordy, okay. Drag a skill card from below to replace one of your old class skills. Oh, Trunks, you came back. Here, you're more interesting than me. Come back over here. Man, I just need a second camera. Boop. There you go. Look all swaggy for the camera. Boom. How about just like that? Oh, the cable keeps on kind of pulling it out of position. There we go. Got it. So on the warrior, I feel like these wild swings are pretty... Oh, or I can just level up a... Okay. Okay, cool. So you can level up a skill, you can level up a card, or you can replace a card. Oh, right. If I'd actually read what was above, I'd have figured that out. Melee attack 4, then draw a card. This can not be played. This card cannot be played. Huh. I don't fully follow how that works then. Defend 3 at the beginning of your turn. On play, defend 3. Okay, so just 3 defense each turn. That also seems pretty good for this character. Defend 7. Choose a friendly character. All damage to that character is transferred to you until the start of your turn. Can I kiss Trunks on the head? I guess I can. Is it going to scare him away? Mm. He's a good kitty. Mmm. I feel like this power is pretty good. I feel like I just get rid of a wild swing. Like, for the cost, like, you're better off just playing swipes. Like, I get that it's the advantage of you don't need to draw multiple swipes. Like, well, maybe it is better. It's just hard to play. Well, I don't know. Maybe 3 isn't too hard to get with all the extra willpower that I get on the Hunter and the Elementalist. I think I'm gonna take a resilience and replace a swipe. Let's try that. With the pile of belongings seized from the humans' possessions of the dead ratlings, there is quite a collection of loot. What does it mean 50% food? As in I get 5 food, or... Are you annoyed now? Fine. I'll chill. Or maybe you just heard something outside. Sure, I feel like I'm about to camp. Let's just get food. Oh, that was 1 food. I feel robbed. While there were some useful items that you have forgone, you are offered a hot meal and a bed for the night. There's even talk of renaming the town in your honor? 50% is filler. Well, I got a town named after me. That seems... I mean, it feels kind of complicated when there's 3 people. I guess the town's just going to be called Rostin Gerard Balkan Berg. It's a great name. Resting. Okay, that's what I needed to figure out here. Vera's been traveling non-stop, and now would be a good time to stop and rest before your heroes are too tired to fight effectively. The more sheltered your current position, the more effective your rest will be. Rest in Ballingenberg. Yeah. Yeah, it's the name of the town now. The more shelter... I already read that. And if you can find a settlement or living world ruin to rest in, such as your current location... Nailed it. I knew this is where I should rest. You can also restore a little bit of health to your heroes. To make a camp, click on the stamina tracker above the thing. Oh, it really wants me to camp. Would it even let me move? Oh, okay. Still kind of tutorial. Camp tutorial. Never mind. Extremely tutorial energy. Although your mission is urgent, you'll need to stop to rest and da da da. Each time you rest, your party will consume one unit of food. Oh. So the three people here are going to share one carrot, and that's going to be filling to them? Wild. You can use the downtime and resources you've collected to improve your hero's dex by choosing one of the available camp actions. Every time you rest, try to do this whenever you can, as your time is limited. Regardless of your activity, you will always need one food and will restore stamina and health based on where you camped. Okay. Okay, so I can just upgrade an item for free? Nifty. Insufficient materials. Man, it really lied to me when it said I should come in here and upgrade an item, didn't it? What is a material? Ah. Can I, like, break these down? Nothing is free. True. Huh. Okay, sturdy bone. Sturdy bone, common crafting material. Dope. Meditate. Use a mystic herb to upgrade or forget a class card from one hero. Is there anything that feels worth upgrading? She improvised attacks did pretty good last time. I guess these are just kind of better, though. Wait, and then what's the other thing? I could also use it to heal an injury if I wanted to. Okay, let's just rest, I guess. Cool. Is that how civilization is spelled? Doesn't civilization have a Z there? Am I wrong? Does Trunks only have one arm? No, he's just very much sleeping on his other arm. There's another arm somewhere in this vicinity here. I don't know if my finger's gonna show up here. There's his other arm. There's the proof. He eventually got scared into revealing his secret arm. Break camp. What the f- is that? Is that water? Oh, hello. Hello, ominous thing off in the distance. Expose. Resting will only restore a minimum amount of stamina. The British disagree? Wait, the British spell civilization wrong? God, come on, Brits. Get it together. Learn how to spell good. You come across a skeletal remains. Yeah, a lot of skeletal remains. Of a common site on the grasslands. Grasslands is a name given to a barren, scorched wasteland that now covers most of Ash. The name comes from the beautiful... Oh, the glasslands. I can read. Yeah, they use S's instead of Z's. So, like, is the upper class spelled upper class? Is it just direct, like, replace all their S's with Z's? Oh, no, they can use S's instead of Z's. Ugh, so Brit. They don't even know where Europe is. I mean, they certainly don't think they're part of Europe, so they're a little lost. Why is your head not in view? There we go. You spot a burrow opening nearby that looks large enough to crawl into. Okay, I found a hole in the ground. Should I crawl into it? Oh my god, that sounds like such a bad idea. But I mean... Every hole is a chance for glory, right? You kind of have to crawl into the glorious hole. Why did the camera just move suddenly? That's so weird. I know, but I need to make DGR proud. Let's see what's in the hole. Okay, Rosted, my hunter, just squeezes into the burrow carrying a makeshift torch. He continues around a slight bend into an empty cavern. Okay, so one guy crawled into a random hole he found on his own, thinking like, yo, this has to be a good idea.
Let's see how this works out for him. I guess nothing happened? Not a glory hole. I said a hole of glory. It's completely different. Let's see what materials we can find in this burned forest. While trekking through a desiccated forest, you hear an unnatural wailing coming from deeper in the trees. Soon you come across a damaged wooden structure that appears to be formed by several trees growing together. Try to block out the noise and enter the abode. What's with these people of seeing, like, terrifying fucking shit and just being like, yo, should we go in? Should we see what's happening in there? Try to block out the noise and enter the abode. I mean, epic reward, though. Turn back the way you came and leave the abode undisturbed. Is that bravery or stupidity? I mean, honestly, bravery and stupidity are just two sides of the same coin. Yeah, sure, YOLO. Jirah, who's Jirah, my warrior, covers her ears and barges open the door with her shoulder. As she looks up, blood trickling from her nose and ears, there's what appears to be the apparition of an elven woman standing perfectly still. That seems fine. This is all good. It's actually hurrah, fair. Is that how? Oh, I took damage. Okay, well that didn't work out for me. I did not get my epic loot. Is that how the British pronounce their J's too? Hurrah. The apparition remains motionless and the sound begins to die down as hurrah pushes forward into the house. From the size and the decor of the dwelling, you guess it was once a retreat for a powerful elven wizard. Oh wait. You take what you can before leaving this cursed place. Oh, so I still do get shit. There we go. Look at that. Epic crafting material. Profit. Alright, let's take a few more steps here. So I assume this is like my timer. I mean, it did say that I was bleeding out of my nose and ears from her screeching, so like, I don't know, I feel like that checks out. Sure. On the path ahead lies the body of a female ratling, who does not seem to be moving. Something doesn't feel right about this sense, though. It looks like a good spot for an ambush. Yeah, I think I'm good on checking the random body just laying out in a very, like, conspicuous location. I'll pass. I'm good. What's this? A settlement? I mean, I kind of need to sleep again already. I'm kind of exposed. Let's just keep on going on, though. I won't regret this. Here, how about there? That looks good. This is on my way. Oh, look, and it's right next to, like, the place I need to go. Perfect. Yeah, let's hop on over here. Drained. Can relate. I feel illiterate and shit right now. Yo, here's your story time for the day. Look at all this reading. This is the most reading I've done in decades. Oh, God, maybe literally. Oh, God. Reminding me of how old I am. You find a group of nomadic humans and ratlings busily packing up their belongings and preparing to move their tribe on. Here's that a number of them have recently been taken by a group of hybrid raiders. Wow, that's just the name of their race. Okay. Hybrids possess either one or two sets of horns protruding from the sides of their heads and varying numbers of spikes on their bodies, which offer significant protection. Okay, so they're porcupines. Sure. They're dark gray to black in color, with a U, these crazy Brits over here, with the thick black hooves instead of feet. Oh, so these are devil people. All this reading makes me hungry? Yeah, you know that those reading munchies that people get. I can't tell if Trunks is moving the bed or if the camera just keeps on moving. There, how about there? Right, I was reading about hybrids. They are taller than humans and possess unmatched strength and superb climbing and jumping abilities. With their dark, insulated skin and slow metabolism, they're especially good at adapting to their environment, recovering from injuries, and tolerating the effects of unpredictable damaged sun. The effects of the unpredictable damaged sun? We damaged the sun? Okay. Sure, why not? Trunks, I feel like I can solve this by just zooming out the camera a little bit, can't I? That's probably the real answer here. Wow. And then I probably need to hit apply, okay. It appears that a number of them have recently been taken. How can you tell by looking at this group that's packing up quickly that some of them were recently taken? That's some impressive, like ability to identify the past based on the current actions of a group. Help out the nomads and agree to catch up with the hybrid raiders. Refuse to help. It seems that the group is well enough provisioned to handle this on their own. I mean, like, I got shit to do. I don't think I'm gonna, you know, I'm just here to get a little nap in. I think I'm not gonna add extra shit to my plate here. Let's get a nappy nap here. Oh, did something just happen in the hallway? Are you interested by the hallway now? Rip. I assume he's gonna come back. I'm too lazy to move the camera. Let's turn it off for now. Oh wait, can I upgrade an item now? No. Nothing uses this epic material that I received. R.I.P. I should narrate audiobooks. Hey, the one time that I did that narration for, what was it, for Bodega's podcast or something? I can't remember where I did the narration of something. I think I did an okay job for that, though. I guess I might as well do a sleppy slep again. There we go. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, it's for the podcast. Yeah. I remember things. You find the remains of an elven palace that is still partially suspended in the treetops. Fucking elves, putting all the shit in luxurious places. From the markings, you are sure that this is the place you are looking for. The Waterstone must be near. Continue. It becomes clear that this palace is not deserted. Hurrah hears a voice from inside, and there are rattling shadows moving the elemental lights. These strange devices provide light from no discernible fuel. Each light appears to be brightly glowing stones contained in a cage of glass and steel. The fact that they are still function after decades of neglect is astonishing. Nifty. Let's beat up on some more rats. Oh, this rat is nowhere near as cute as the ranger rats. Elite enemies. You have encountered an elite enemy. Elite enemies are generally tougher and more dangerous than standard enemies. But more importantly, each has a unique dangerous ability that should always be aware of when fighting these enemies. To view an elite enemy, hover over it. Cool. The sorcerer is the scary one. Got it. Swarm leader. I'm surprised they didn't say epic enemies. All other enemies gain +2 defense at the start of their turn. That's really fucking obnoxious. Okay. Can I just kill one of these guys before they get, wait, why do my guys have extra health? What is that symbol there? Whatever, won't question it. Okay. But so I can see what, okay, so I can see what these guys are pulling from their deck. For the most part, they can just deal one. Deal one and draw a card, deal 2 damage if your previous card played was a move card. Interesting. It's a trap. Okay, well. Study. Target a character to gain a copy of each of their active powers. Wait, is this a power? No, it's not. Okay, so study does jack shit right now. That's good to know. Prepare seems like something that should always be played. Each time you play a card that deals magic damage, gain 1 willpower. As far as I know, she is the only one that can deal magic damage. I'll probably just burn Unstable Blast, put that on, and then cantrip. Like, I could... I probably don't really want to move her too much. I feel like I want to get my warrior up to, like, this choke. Let's see. 1, 2... Or maybe put my warrior here to help give defense to the elementalist, and then I can just move him up to here or something. Probably get this improvised attack in as well. So spend study to move that up and then move him up to here to defend. Maybe it's extra health because they're a little deaf now, like how your other senses are boosted when one doesn't work. Where did Trunks Cam go? Trunks heard something in the hallway and went to investigate the door. And so the cam is gone because the Trunks is gone for now, but I assume he'll come back. He doesn't look like he's on a comfortable part of the floor, so I assume he'll return at some point. Okay. I think I've worked out what I'm doing here. Oh right, I need willpower first. I was burning this, doing this. Oh, that's cool. So it shows specifically what is blocking it. And I'm going to advance to here. Oh, I could have gained one willpower. I wonder if there's... So now he's going to... Oh, right. And get the willpower for someone else to attack, maybe. Let's see. Let's finish figuring out what I want to do with her. Probably just activate the cantrip and then move up one. And then burn this, move here. May I just burn both of these? Put some treats in his bed. Man, he hasn't even finished his dinner yet. Why does he deserve treats? I don't think he deserves it right now. I think... what do I want to do here? I probably don't need to double defend. Probably just the two defense will be enough. It's probably just the Bowman hitting me this turn. Right, that's saying that's... Well, it's playing three cards. I guess moving... okay, let's be safe. Let's do that. It's like burning on any character. Okay. Wait. This guy can hit me from there? That seems cheap. Does not say it can see me. Oh man, there's so... Okay, there's a lot of things happening here. Woo! Okay. Named effects are ongoing effects that help or hinder characters in battle. Named effects are exposed in card descriptions in bold. Burning are exposed. While all named effects have a unique disadvantage or benefit. What? Disadvantage or advantage? I feel like that would be a better... Whatever. They all follow the same basic rules. A named effect will last until the end of the affected character's turn. Applying the same named effect more than once will not double up the effect, but will increase the duration so it may last longer than a single turn. Okay, so if I get burned twice, it doesn't deal double burn damage, it just lasts twice as long. Well, active and name effects are displayed on the icons, cool. Man, did not really want her to have swipes this turn. Oh, I can redraw, can't I? Click to redraw. Yes. You have no cards in the recycle shrine to redraw. To redraw, first recycle the cards you want to replace and then click here again. Okay. So I want to replace both of those. Okay, that seems better. I can just reach from here, right? Yes. So she can not quite kill. That's unfortunate. Every time you play a card that deals ranged damage, gain one willpower. Oh lord, so much going on. Okay, so 5 just kills that. So maybe that would be a good idea. I definitely want this activated on my warrior. One, two. So this is really the only person I can hit this turn. This is the only person I can hit this turn reasonably. Then again, like, this is... Okay. I think I'm going to do this. Move forward to here. Every time you play a card that deals ranged damage, gain 1 willpower. I don't think I can really get this in play this turn. I guess the other option is I can... I could try and get some damage in on this Rattling Guard too with Force Missile. So I could do that, deal 2 damage, do 2 damage there. I guess that's the other thing, is that this defense is just going to keep on stacking up, isn't it? Maybe I just want to try and get the warrior, like... except I can't really just get the warrior up in the sorcerer's face because of zone of control from the 2 guards in these locations. Okay. Maybe I just recycle these 3. That gives me 4, and then I can do 2. Okay. And then I'm gonna do focus, and then I'm gonna do power shot to kill there. I'm gonna gain 1 from that. And then I'm gonna burn this to move forward. To here, this holds the choke, and then do this for defense. I think that made sense. Do these guards have attacks? Oh my word. I'm never gonna make it through that. Okay, so the burning takes place at the end of the turn, so I'll want to defend on her to avoid the 2 status damage. Melee attack for 3 or range attack for 2 also hits anyone directly behind the target. So I assume that, like, okay. So yes, it's directly behind based on the angle that I'm coming from. Probably want to just prepare as well. Advance on the warrior, maybe to here, so that I'm not being tag teamed. And then double strike's gonna gain me 4 armor anyways. And then, I can't quite Arcane Blast, so I will need to move the Elementalist up. Okay. So probably want to use this for movement. And then I'm probably actually going to move like that to defend the Elementalist. Arcane Blast makes me giggle. Why? How can that be? How can that be made funny? Okay. And then apply the burning here. Force missiles. Advance here. I feel like I'm going to be tight on energy is the thing. right? Do this advance, just so I get an idea of what I'm going to be working with here. Okay, and then this is going to gain me one willpower. Right, it's the first time? Every time you play a ranged damage attack, gain one willpower. Okay, so these are free. Okay, so that's pretty good. I think it's because it makes you think of Anal Blast. Huh. Well, that's one place that a brain can go. Oh, I'm so dumb. I wanted to play the Flame Fan first so that I wouldn't be hitting my own character. Well, rip. I guess I don't play that this turn, just see if I can use it later. Or maybe I'm gonna have to burn it here for protection, actually. Yeah, and I think I'm keep. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna do this, and then I'm gonna. Okay, I almost made it through the one rat guards thing. Yeah, I think I'm just good. Pull all enemies within. Oh. Well, there goes my big brain play of trying to keep my elementalist hidden. Actually, that's better positioning. Oh, except I didn't get Fan of Flames. Is this permadeath? This is permadeath. This is what they know and what they say in the industry as a roguelite. A roguelite. I guess this is a roguelite. I think you're unlocking equipment, actually. There is some continued progression, but this is very much a roguelite deck builder. While your heroes is in position to perform a combo strike. I definitely already know what a combo strike is. Okay. Oh, I should have kept the other one. Basically, roguelike is each time you play, it's exactly the same. There's zero progression, right? A roguelike is each playthrough is a totally fresh playthrough, and nothing that you did before impacts any future games. And a roguelite is going to have some form of like meta progression. So in some way, your next run will have potentially something different about it. Whether that's like you upgraded your character in some way, or you unlocked some cards into a card pool, or items into an item pool, or something like that. Roguelike is Spelunky, yes. Thanks not more for the follow. Let's see here. What am I doing this turn? Hopefully getting some damage in on. Hopefully just killing this rat guard if I can. The 5 attack definitely helps here. Probably will be using. So I don't know. Am I able to move? Okay, so I can just move her back if I want to. Good to know. I could also move up here, and Arcane Blast would go through both of them. I can also use Swipe for the combo. Except I don't think the combo strike works, right? I think Hurrah isn't able to combo strike because they have two enemies on them. I'll remember that because they both have the K consonant. Okay, fair. And it's like, what are you talking about at first? But no, that makes sense. God, it feels really strong that powers don't go away over time. Shocked. When hit by a melee or ranged attack, deal 1 status damage to all friendly targets within 2 spaces. I did not even notice that. Consonant. Okay. Oh, I have to hit that one, right? That's unfortunate. I wonder if there's value in, like, just starting to get damage on the sorcerer, actually. Like, maybe go up to here, so that the shock damage doesn't chain to my other characters, and then start hitting the really scary one back there. I don't know, it's like, do I take out the thing that's clearly the more annoying target, or do I try and... Well, this one's gonna take forever to get through at this point. All attacks deal plus one damage per adjacent enemy. Yeah, I think I wanna use the ranger to start hitting the sorcerer. Okay. Let's do that. Let's move up to here. And then power shot. Okay, great. Every time you play a card that deals melee damage, gain one willpower. I don't think I can really afford, well. Yeah, I don't know how I am able to actually use that here. What does willpower do? Willpower is what I use to, is what you use. It's your resource in the game. I don't know what card games you know to compare it to, but like, right, this is my willpower pool up here. This is how much willpower I actively, it's my mana. Yes, it's my mana in this game. Exactly. Three defend at the beginning of your turn. So I already have the defense that I'm going to get. I think I'm gonna spend swipe here, do blow to the head here, hopefully get the combo attack off. Use the advance for defense, and then use advance to move here, unstable blast force missiles. I think that should work fine. Okay. Oh, right. I forgot that I'm getting the extra defense off. Wait, why did she get a defense? Oh, she's also shocked. Huh. Maybe I should have done something different there. Immaturity is my escape from reality. Well, you know, everyone needs something. Maybe I should plan this out. Am I actually gonna have what I need to use adrenaline here? Here. Yeah, I just force missiles here. Magic attacks deal 2 damage to a target within 3 spaces and 1 random damage to enemies within 2 spaces. So it will reach here. Oh, not enough willpower, right. Oh, wait. Oh, I meant to wait, no, I can go back. Right. I can undo my stupid. Boom. Force missiles. Brogan. What a name. Oh, I just took his power off. Okay. Oh, that's why that showed up before, is because I hit him, which burned the resilience to take off his power. Undumb it. Yeah, that's certainly what I just did there, was undumbify. And then this. Okay, I worked through a lot of armor here. Maybe the 5 armor is enough. Maybe I will activate adrenaline and have fucked up by having not done whatever before. Sure. Okay, well, she's definitely going to take damage. It feels weird that I draw at the end of my turn rather than the beginning of my next turn. Okay, no, let's stop getting the damage cards. Rip, there goes my spell power. That's fine. Down here? Oh! Can you chill? Oh, she is so dead. She is very dead, right? Oh! Okay. Never worried. I was always confident that I was fine. No buys yet. Premature buy. Everything is fine. Spark. So what is the range of this attack? How can I make sure she doesn't get hit by this? Inflict burning on any character. Oh, never mind. You just hit them. Okay. There's no dodging that. Except I need to get away. Well, the spark only activates if he gets hit, except this guy has like infinite range. Okay, I really want to kill the sorcerer then this turn. That's not what I meant to do. Except I'm not gonna, That's like almost impossible here. Okay, so she's definitely gonna be defending a lot this turn. And by a lot, I mean the max I can defend is 4 no matter what. Oh, I also can't advancing here should be fine. Cause he won't be able to advance past. I'm still like, yeah, I feel like this is gonna be a rip to what's her name? Oh god, I already forgot. To Elementalist. What was the Elementalist's name? I don't think I have a good way of seeing. Right, if Spark just has infinite range, then like... Well, no, Spark is fine. Spark doesn't deal damage, right? It only applies burn. So maybe fine. Maybe fine. Or do I recycle both of these and hope to get... I guess no other card I have is better. Let's call her Ella. Ella the Elementalist. We got some creativity in the chat. Nothing here feels great, per se. And I think I'm gonna use this to run the fuck away. Can't get 2 away. I can move him back 1. And get spacing. And then I want to advance here. Okay. So I can make this deal double damage. That seems good. I didn't see you come up with any. Okay, fair enough. Okay, let's see if Ella here dies. I think I'm fine, actually. I think Ella's gonna survive here. I think Ella's gonna survive here. Oh, wait, what? How did he just move from there to there? Uh-oh. Okay. No, that's fine. That's fine. Okay. Your heroes can gain a number of redraws, which can be used. Yeah, I've already used a redraw once. Can I make this go away, or is this just gonna be on my screen for the rest of this turn? Could I redraw this? One great way to use redraws is to replace weakness cards in your hand with other... Oh, okay, so this... Try this now. To do this, recycle the weakness card and at least one other card in your character's hand. After doing... Okay, so that and at least one other card. I'm probably not gonna be advancing. Okay. Didn't really need the swipe. Hit that, and then I can power shot and improvise shot. I still have the extra willpower from using ranged attacks. So that should be fine. So he can hit either one of them. So I wonder how I damage to kill one of these guys here. I feel like I probably do. So this is 5. This is 2, 7, 11. And then I can apply burning. Okay. So I can kill here if I can play all my cards. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I don't feel like I'm going to get 9 energy here, but maybe I'm wrong. These are actually 1 less. This is actually 1. Each time you play a card that deals melee damage, gain 1 willpower. So this is actually 1 to play. This is 2 to play. And this is 3, 4, 5. Okay, maybe I do have this. I think I'm actually gonna be a little bit short here. That's fine. I don't really need to play Flame Fan, actually. Okay. I think this just works out pretty well, actually. Well, actually. Wait, why did that deal 1? Wasn't that supposed to deal 2? Nope, I'm illiterate. Oh, it's plus 2 damage, not plus 1 damage. Did I count for that? 4, 5, 6. Okay, wait, so these two together deal 6. This deals 3 to 6, so no, that's not better. Okay. So 6, 7, 8, 9? That has 9, so I'm assuming that nothing else unsurprising happens, I'm good. Okay. Not playing Flame Fan. Double strike. Oh, right, I have combos on her too. Oh. Hello. I'm super good on damage. Okay. And then this, and I'm going to advance away again because Ella is scared. Is he still shocked? He's not. No one is still shocked. Maybe there. I'm going to move there. Man, and we thought Ella was dying. Never. That's fine. Wow, okay. These warriors got a decent amount of damage. Wait, what did the sorcerer do? Just this? He said, see you later, not goodbye. Gain 2 willpower at the start of your turn. Okay, he had a chill turn. That's good. So I wonder if my ranged characters can just kill this guard so that Hurrah can move up. Okay, so I probably want to redraw here. 2 redraws remaining. Is it a shared redraw pool? Hmm. Deal 3 damage or ranged attack 2. Also hits anyone directly behind. Honestly, a lot of these feel pretty meh. That will chain. That's not terrible. I think I want to redraw here. Cards in deck. Power Shot Study. Does Study get me much? I mean, it denies the sorcerer from having willpower. Okay, I think I'm going to do this and redraw. I guarantee those. So I can study. Power Shot deals 5. So then I need to deal 8 over here. I don't think I'm going to get to 8 from here. Okay, so I'm not making it to the wizard this turn. And if I'm not making it to the wizard this turn, I don't need advance. So I can probably get rid of both of these. I'm guaranteed getting blow to the head. That's unfortunate. Oh wait, it can be recycled? I do get willpower for that? Oh, that's not that bad of a card then, I guess. Okay. Probably worth it to just get rid of Goad right now. There's no way for this guy to get in range, right? Running Shot doesn't move that far. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Can I study that? Oh! I did not mean to target myself with that. Wait, how did I... Oh, I took my own... Oh wait, maybe that was good to just do on myself. But why did that not... Okay, I did get the study back there. Okay. Oh, I didn't realize I could study myself. Huh. Wait, is that good? Yeah, I do just do that. Wait a second. Okay, and I get that. You know, prepare. Each time you play a card that deals range damage, gains. So then I'd be gaining 2. Do that. Actually, realistically, that's probably not going to be worth it. So Power Shot, I go back up to 1. Running Shot, I again go back up to 1 when I use that. Well, Power Shot, blow to the head. And another running shot there. Okay. Setting yourself is just called therapy. I mean, yo, they've been through some shit here. Like, the therapy's probably good for them. I think I do want... prepare over here. Force missiles that will bounce. That gives me the extra 2. Okay, if I'm running shot, I need to realistically running shot here to get it off. Okay. This target's out of range. Oh, huh. I knew that. Really grouping them up. That's probably a poor choice. Do this, do this. And then... Okay, so I should have played focus before. Each time... Can I not... Oh, so I cannot stack multiples of the same thing on me. Okay, good to know. Pair, focus. Okay, maybe fine. What's he got? You do a zoomy boomy. A zoomy boomy. Isn't that the Breath of the Wild stuff? Man, I'm really surprised Trunks never came back. Maybe I should have just put the webcam back on myself. Okay, he seems scared. That seems good for me. What's Force Strike? That's a melee attack, so that's fine. She's not gonna be getting in melee range. Deals 2 damage and inflicts shock to 2 random enemies. Okay, so make sure that she has 2 defense at the end of the round. I think I'm throwing both of those back, using my last redraw. I did get the advance that I was hoping for. Working my way on up here. Get the energy. And then... okay. Not quite gonna be in range. Wait, so can I use advance to get movement too? I can. Wild. Your next melee or range attack this turn deals double damage. Okay, so I just hold that this turn. Trunks couldn't deal with all the fame. Fair. Advance. So advance here and then advance here. And let's defend anyways. Let's do that. That's fine. That's fine. Oh, wow. That line of sight. And I just had my sorceress, like, over here. She would have easily been able to move up. Obnoxious. Okay. Well, 3-6. So I have potential. I can RNG hit this and deal enough damage. Actually, I might just have it this turn. Let's see. Advance. Oh, wait. Did I speak too soon? Is it time for the return? Whoops. Boom. The return. The return of the true hero of the stream. The true person that has kept Ella alive. So let's go ahead and wild swing. 3-6, let's high roll. That was a 3. Okay, great. God, if I can just... Oh. Well... That return was very short-lived. RIP. Well, that was awkward. I don't want to perfect aim this attack, right? Or I guess I do because of how my special power works. Okay. One of those, play perfect aim. Aim, play running shot. Easy. I feel so empty. Ella fucking survived. Wild. A legendary item. And click here to. Oh, wow. You get to choose what item you want. Okay, Ella, get that level up. legendary is going to be better than epic. I feel like I want to get rid of these swipes. That seems like a very obvious thing to replace. So what's good for new moves? Deal 2 magic damage that inflicts shock on an enemy within 2 spaces and then jumps to a different enemy within 2 spaces and repeat. Wow. No, this is not a roguelike. This is a roguelite. This is a roguelite. I don't know how the leveling works between, like, missions. I don't know if when I set out for another mission to go find some, you know, go find the firestone that the elves use to place volcanoes in their foyers for heating or whatever, if she's still going to be level 2 or whatever. I'm not really sure. I mean, 0 willpower for 4 defense on any character seems okay too. After you play a card that deals magic damage, all future attacks deal +2 damage. Lose +2 from the damage bonus each round. After you play a card that deals magic damage, all future attacks deal +2 damage. Oh, so that's just stacking. So like if I play 4 magic attacks in a turn, I have a +8 going on. But you lose it rapidly if you're not attacking. Interesting. I don't know if I really have enough magic spells right now to keep that alive. This is also, Flame Fan has been very hard to actually get off. This isn't a magic attack. I think I like the static. Wait, so is this also not a magic attack, technically? No, deal magic damage. Okay, I think I'm going to take the static discharge here. Inflict immobilized and defend 2 to all characters in target area. Ooh, that's a complicated... What are you, a Pikachu? Sure, why not? That is literally, like, isn't it like Pichu's, like, signature move, static discharge? I think that's, like, the thing that Pichu starts at when hatched from an egg. Where's the... Hit him with the Bulbapedia here. What's Pichu's egg move? Mariachi Fireball is going to be very confused since we've already established this stream that Pokemon is a foreign concept over here. It's not? I swear a static discharge is a Pokemon thing. Just static? I guess there isn't a static discharge. I lied. Rip. How the hell is that even possible? How the hell is what even possible? That Mariachi Fireball doesn't know what Pokemon is? I mean, they can explain that themselves. Okay, I swear I have a Pokemon card where that is a move. I thought so. Yo, don't take that up with me. He's all on that... What was the shit he was talking about earlier? He's all on that Tranzor Z game up in here. Seeing all the Tranzors. I'm gonna take this. Get out of here. Swipe. Burn. Oh. Wait, I have 2 level ups remaining? Oh, okay. Melee attack and draw a movement card from your deck. Or Luxio? What's Luxio? Oh, that little baby. Okay, huh. Did I not play Gen 4? Which one is Gen 4? I don't recognize Luxio. Yeah, you're just throwing names at me. Maybe I didn't play 4. I don't really remember what Diamond and Pearl was. No Trunks. Go back to your bed. Don't come up on the TV. Deadeye. All range attacks deal +2 range damage. I mean, that's pretty nice too. Inflict exposed. Characters take one additional damage from all damage sources. Cannot have stealth. Each named effect loses one stack at the end of the affected character's turn. Here, come here. What do you want to fight me for? What are you going to fight me for? Little bitey kitty right now. You're so fierce. Don't you think you're so fierce? Range attack to inflict and mobilize if the attack is not blocked. That sounds pretty good. Yeah, let's take that. What? 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 One more level up. I still don't know if Ella actually gets health back on level ups, but let's do this anyways. Look at the top two cards of your deck. Draw one and reduce its willpower cost to zero. I mean, I have a lot of things that cost two. That sounds pretty good. Was it? Look at the top two cards of your deck. Yeah, that sounds pretty good. Whenever you are attacked by an adjacent enemy... What's your problem? What's your problem? Little punk. Again, stone barrier sounds good. I don't think I want to take a second static discharge. I think I want to kind of see what it does. Whenever you're attacked by an adjacent enemy, inflict burning on the attacker. On play, defend two. Or defend three. Pfft, numbers are hard. I'm going to take draw power. Okay. You go about thoroughly search. Oh right, there's a story going on here. Did anyone remember that there was a story happening? I did not. You go thoroughly searching the elven ruins and find the waterstone in what was once a garden terrace. The artifact is unfortunately completely inert and would be useless in its current state. Darn. New objective: charge the water gem. Recommended levels 4 to 6. Well, I'm levels 2 to 3. I should be fine, right? They must locate a scry pool with power to restore the artifact. It's 10:21. Oh man, okay. Maybe this is where I call it for now then. Before leaving, what do you want? What do you want? Before leaving, you collect some supplies that the ratlings had stored near where your battle took place. Cool. Some food, some herb. I need to find the Pichu card. We'll find it. There we go. How about that? There, camera stay right there. Okay. We did the survival. Oh, there we go. Yeah, Ella, whose name is apparently Malkin. I don't think I can rename her from here, right? Yeah. Malkin. She does not look like a Malkin to me. Oh, right. I forgot that I had these leather bracers that I could have equipped. I feel like I want these ones again. And then a shield. Couldn't find it. RIP. Melee attack that deals damage equal to your current defense. Well, Hurrah had some crazy defense, so that seems pretty good. Oh, wait. This is just better, right? I mean, I guess it's not just better because it's packing your deck. But I'm not big-brained enough on this game yet to know, like... Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 cards, and you're drawing 3 a turn. Someone's meowy over there now. I think I'll switch to that. I think that would be fine. and then a legendary item. Wait, so I'm able to see... So I can see what these are. Okay, not the upgrade material. Nebula's star. Isn't Nebula a character in, like, the Marvel stuff? Rally, gain four... Wait, spend 2 willpower to gain 4 willpower. That seems like a weird move. Gain 2 willpower at the start of your turn. This costs 1 less willpower for every power you already have active. And then spend 2 willpower to gain 6 willpower. That all seems very odd. Plus one pill power every turn. Every time you take damage, take 1 additional damage. Okay, wait, so this is like a special thing on top of... Okay, so they also have like special effects. She's the blue one. Yeah. That's what I thought she was the blue one. So this could be equipped by Hurrah. Move 4, defend 1 per space moved. That seems really good. After you play a move card, deal 2 melee damage to all adjacent enemies. This does not trigger combo strikes. Each hero creates 2 cards in hand from a choice of Shiv, Simple Shot, and Guard. I guess I can't see what those are, but that looks a lot better than the amulet to me. Each time your talent triggers each turn, refresh it. What's her talent again? Taunt. Once per turn after you play a card and are adjacent to an enemy, defend 2 on all other heroes. That seems really good. And this could go on either Ella or Rostin. Right, that's his name. Magic attack. 2 and inflict chilled on a target. Chilled is -1 to all attack, range, magic damage, and -1 movement. Each named effect. Okay. That's pretty good. Except I don't really... On both those characters, I don't really want them to have stab or critical strike. All of your attacks deal +1 damage per stack of chilled on your target. Okay, I think I'm gonna take the helmet here. Remember what I was just saying about not worrying about overstacking my deck, and now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 cards in my... Oh, 18 cards in my deck? 9 are direct damage, 3 allow you to move, 5 are defensive, 4 powers. Do the powers get taken out of my deck? I was paying attention. If when a power is applied to you, if you can shuffle it and draw it again. I assume not. It feels odd if you can have multiple copies of a power, like, active. But, who knows? Okay, I think I'm gonna call this one. I'm gonna call this stream for now, and then I'll probably pick this up tomorrow. At some time. Hopefully a little bit earlier in the night. Maybe, like, a 6 p.m. Eastern stream or something instead of an 8 p.m. like today or something, and we'll continue seeing if this party can find their way to refreshing the water stone or whatever. I still don't fully understand what these different symbols here mean, but I don't know, maybe we'll figure that out as we go along. Okay, let's see. Who's streaming right now? Who can we raid? Warp World is doing the podcast? Sure, let's send it over to Mickey X Water, Grand Pooh Bear, and Jakku with whatever they're talking about right now. What are they talking about?
And it's like, we don't need to
do something that. About their favorite games. Okay, let's we're gonna raid Jackie. Send it right on over to them. Anyways, okay. See everyone later. Bye.